Let's take a look at another query. So this time around, we're going to try to find all the users, or specifically the user IDs, I'll put that on here, where the user has commented on the first two photos. So that would be a photo with the ID of 1 or 2, and the user has added more than 2 comments on those photos. So this is a little bit tricky one, but again, we can once again see that we have 2 different filtering criteria. The first one, we're going to make sure that we kind of filter out the initial set of rows. We only want to take a look at comments, in this case, where they were added to the first 2 photos, or a photo with ID of 1 or an ID of 2. That is an initial filter on our first set of rows here. Then the second filter we want to add is definitely talking about adding in some kind of counting functionality. We got to take a look and find users where they added more than 2 comments. So we need to count up the number of comments. Because we need to do a counting and then a filtering operation, that is a sign that we need to do a group by and then a having using an aggregate function. So once again, let's walk through this in diagram format and then actually write out the query. Okay, so to get started, we want to apply the initial filtering criteria here. We only want to find comments that were added to the first 2 photos. So we're definitely going to be working off the comments table. We only want to find comments where the photo ID is 1 or 2. So I would delete this row right here because it has a photo ID of 3. I would delete that one and that one. And now I'm left with only rows where they are comments added to photos with an ID less than 2. Or I guess I should say here less than 3. Less than or equal to 2. All right, so now we're going to group all these things together based upon the user ID. It looks like I've got a user ID of 1, 3, and 5. So I can put together my groups here. 1, 3, and 5. Those are my unique user ID values. I'll then assign each of these different rows to one of these groups based upon their user ID. So these first 2 rows go into the first group because they have a user ID of 1. The next one has a user ID of 3 right here, and then a user ID of 5. Then finally, we're going to count up the number of rows in each of these different groups. So once again, it will be a simple count star. It looks like this one has 2 entries or 2 rows inside of it. And then we've got a 1 and a 1. Now finally, we want to do some filtering on these groups. And this step, or this second filter, is going to achieve this step right here. We're going to do some filtering based upon an aggregate function. So this is where we would make use of that having statement. We would say something to the effect of having greater than 2 comments. Well, in this case, looks like we've only got one here that has even 2 comments. So we'll say more than or equal to 2 comments. That'll just make this a little bit easier. So we actually have some useful results. So it looks like we would drop off these 2 right here, and we would be left with just user with ID 1. And so we would select user ID. That would show that user ID of 1 right there. We could also select a count star, and that would display the number of comments that this user had made to the 2 initial photos. Okay, so that's the idea. So now we're going to repeat this process and actually write out the SQL for it. I am going to change the numbers just a little bit to better suit our data set that we are currently working with. We're going to say that we want to find photos where the user commented on the first 50 photos, and we want to find users who added more than or equal to 20 comments. And actually, we'll just go with a straight more than 20 comments on those first 50 photos. Okay, so that's our criteria right there. Let's go write out a query for it. All right. So we would do a select. We'll leave select empty for right now. Like I've said many times before, it's frequently a lot easier to put together all the other statements and then kind of reflect on the data you actually have accessible and then write out your actual selection or the columns that you want to actually display. So we would start off with comments. We would then apply our initial filtering criteria using that where statement. So the goal of that initial where is going to be to make sure that we only take a look at the first 50 photos. So out of all these different comments, we want to find the ones with a photo ID less than 50. And we can make this a less than or equal to 50 or just less than 50. It doesn't really make a difference. I don't really care either way whether you want it to be the first 50 or 50 inclusive. Either way is totally fine. Then after the where step, we would then do our group by. We're going to group by user ID to find the number of photos ultimately that had been created by each user. So we're going to group by the user ID. And then we're going to do our second filtering step. We know that this second filtering step has to use a having statement, or that having keyword, because we are trying to do filtering of groups. And in addition, we are doing some filtering that is going to rely upon using an aggregate function. Anytime we're trying to filter groups, or anytime we're trying to filter using an aggregate function, we want to think about that having keyword. So in this case, we want to do a having, and we want to count each group and find the users that have more than 20 comments. So I'll do a having count star. So that's going to count all the different rows in each of these different groups. And we'll say greater than 20. All right, so those are our two filter statements. Everything's looking good. Now the last thing we'll do is add in our actual select. In this case, we'll print out the user ID, because remember, we can only select columns that have been grouped by or are the product of doing some aggregate function. We cannot select any of these inner columns inside of here because we've made use of group by. So I'm going to select the user ID, and then I'll also print out the number of comments that those users made. So I'll do a user ID and then a count star to print out the number of comments that each of them created. And let's run this. And there we go. So it looks like for the first 50 photos, user with ID 1 added 23 comments, and user with ID 4 added 22 comments. All right, so that's having. We've now taken a look at two examples of it. And again, as I've repeated many times, every time that we are trying to filter groups, we want to think about having. And any time that we are trying to filter groups based upon some aggregate function, we want to think about having. Let's take a pause here and continue in just a moment.